In my previous video, I warn you against the risk of breaking your Apple Silicon M1 MacBook Pro, MacBook Air or Mac Mini. If you will erase your SSD in a good will, you will then be able to restore clean macOS Big Sur onto it back. In fact, that's exactly what happened to me with this one. Unfortunately, there is currently a bug in macOS or firmware, which is still not fixed at this moment. But don't worry, there is an easy and fast solution how to bring back your Apple Silicon M1 Mac to life. So, clean up your tears. I will show you in this video easy way and step by step how to do it. Hi, I'm Teresa from Morgonaut.cloud and I provide personal individual support with Apple Mac, Windows, Linux and server builds. So if you would need any help, just join my website membership. Link is in this video description and I will help you during a video call and remote session directly to your computer in front of your eyes. Make sure you click the subscribe button below, hit the bell next to it and choose all notifications so you won't miss any of my future videos. Really, don't worry, the whole procedure is in fact super easy and straightforward and I will show you everything live, step by step. So, what will you need? Unfortunately, you will need some another healthy Mac. It can be really any Mac, Intel or M1, does not matter. Then, all you will need is just USB-C to USB-C cable. All of you have probably the original Apple charger, which came with the M1 MacBooks. So in this demonstration, I will use exactly this one. One important thing. On the bricked machine, you have to connect it to the topmost port, simply to the port closest to the screen. And now connect the second end of the cable to your healthy Mac. So, on the right I have the bricked MacBook Pro M1, which I will bring back to life using the left one, in this case MacBook Air M1. Now, download Apple Configurator 2 application from Apple App Store. Direct link I prepared for you in this video description and open this app. Now, let's shut down the bricked MacBook and during start, you will need to follow exactly this procedure of pressing keys. Really listen carefully. Press the start button and keep it pressed. After about a second, also press left control and left option key. And at the same time on the right side, press right shift key. So, keep holding all these keys together for about 10 seconds. Then release all keys, but still keep pressing only the power button, until you will see on the healthy MacBook display the DFU rectangle. So again, press start button and keep it pressed. After about a second, also press left control, left option key and right shift key. Keep holding all these together for about 10 seconds. Then release all keys, but still keep pressing only the power button until you will see on the healthy MacBook the DFU rectangle. Congratulations! The most difficult part is done. Now, click somewhere inside of the DFU rectangle and in the top menu choose Actions and Restore. Now it will download the latest macOS installer and firmware and it will be automatically transferred to the bricked MacBook Pro M1. So, now just sit and relax, smoke some good things, get a beer, because this will take long time. In my case, it took about 15 minutes. When this will all finish, your bricked MacBook will automatically reboot and you will be greeted with the same welcome screen you can see on all Apple devices when you will start them for the first time. In fact, we have done now the same exact process Apple is doing on their site when preparing new Macs for shipping to customers. Congratulations! Now you fixed your bricked Apple Silicon M1 Mac. Now you can set up this MacBook as a fresh device from scratch, but you can also restore it from Time Machine Backup or even directly clone everything from some another your Mac. I personally tested all of these methods and all worked without any problem. So, as I promised on the beginning, it's nothing difficult, but super easy. In fact, I will use since now this method to deploy all my new devices. This Apple Configurator app is very useful. You can use it for many other use cases, also for iOS devices. So I would recommend read documentation and enjoy it. I linked for you the official Apple Configurator 2 user guide Apple support page in this video description. So, I hope I made your day again a little better. If so, please click on the like button below. Don't forget to subscribe, hit the bell next to it and choose all notifications so you won't miss any of my future videos. Click also the share button and share this video with your friends so it can help to more people. Morgonaut is always here to help. And of course, don't forget to watch my other videos. So, that's all for today. Thank you for watching and see you next time, my friends.